Paul Gauguin was 54 years old when he died of a heart attack, caused by malnourishment, an overdose of morphine, and a lot of alcohol. Prior to his death, Gauguin had been struggling with an existential crisis in which he painted this.
It's called Devenu Que Sommes-nous When Sommes-nous, and roughly translates to, where do we come from, what are we, where are we going?
My name is Javier.
And my name's Jada Lynn.
In this short documentary, we'll be taking a look at and analyzing Gauguin's final question to the world, where are we going?
In 1895, 2 years before the painting was finished, Gauguin had moved to Tahiti, an island in French Polynesia, to get away from the mockery from his lack of success as an artist in Paris.
It's all good for him until early 1897. The land he lived on was sold, and when he tried building a new home elsewhere, the bank eventually said, no money, no house. A bit later, Gauguin received a letter from overseas that his favorite daughter, Aline, had died from pneumonia.
Left with no food and virtually no money, Paul Gauguin decided to write, more so paint, his quote-unquote final letter to the world.
Today's modern tools help us understand the past. We've greatly improved our understanding of who we used to be as a collective, and gone to heights that anybody more than a century ago could never reach.
Though humanity has continued to evolve, we as a species are moving so quickly that it's not easy to tell where we'll end up. Moral questions arise as controversial projects and topics like CRISPR, a genome-altering technology that has the capability to change the human species, develop in relative silence while we all live our lives.
Despite all modernization, we are, after all, still humans. Our nature doesn't change, our tools do. There are bound to be repetitions, regardless of new scientific or social changes to our world's ambience.
Let's go backwards a bit here. Here we are, the Renaissance, the scientific revolution. During this time period, the father of science, Galileo Galilei, spent years studying the stars and proved that the Earth was in fact not the center of the universe. And despite having the evidence to support the claims, he was ejected by the church and silenced for 200 years past his death, when his research was finally publicly released.
Now what does this have to do with where we're headed? Well, it seems as if over the past century, we've gone through a second scientific revolution. From the creation of atomic bombs, space exploration, vaccines, the internet, to self-driving cars, scientific advancement has progressed faster than we've ever seen before.
Gauguin lived and died in an era when the world was still trying to assert itself, and wasn't focused on thinking of new ideas, just spreading the old ones. Now that we've settled into our territory, how, or more specifically, where are we going to end up?
For many people at this point in time, the future is unstable and unsafe. But if we look at it more in depth, humanity might just make it. It's up to us which route we decide to go on. But in the end, what we decide as a human race would affect everyone living together on Earth.
On the brighter, more hopeful path, we'll have another age of exploration. Except this time we won't be sailing a couple thousand miles. The next true final frontier is
space.
Though the US has been the only country to land a man on the moon, and other countries have grazed the vacuum of space with probes, none of them have been able to set up a base and start a small civilization that can support life.
Just in the past few years, we've been lucky enough as a species to start the planning of this challenging endeavor. The first age of exploration in the mid-1400s, and the one we may have next, may not have the same intentions, but they might have similar results. Of course, for now, there's only a chance that humanity settles within the solar system, but that doesn't mean that it's impossible for us to solve several important worldwide issues with it, given the new territory to build housing, farming, and infrastructure on. Cities in space would free up space on Earth, bringing about solutions to things such as global warming, excessive trash, habitat destruction, and overpopulation.
On the more possibly realistic end of the rope, the world gets too ahead of itself, and we end up going in a self-destructive circle. Only difference is that this time, with all of our weapons, we could inadvertently destroy modern civilization as we know it. History has a tendency to repeat itself, and problems and issues that should have been left behind are still apparent in present times. Outdated issues such as racism, sexism, and homophobia are still prevalent today. It seems that since agriculture was discovered and ancient societies began to arise, humans have created ways that divide each other into unnecessary groupings that are built upon ignorance. If we aren't able to get over our differences and reach a level of understanding, the world could cease to progress.
In conclusion, Paul Gauguin died not knowing where humankind would lead the world, and because of seemingly desperate times, we might not be able to pull all the way through to save ourselves. Human greed and ignorance, the roots of most everyday problems like pollution and overpopulation, have only increased and escalated over time. There is hope, however, that in the few coming years we might just find a way to reduce or even minimize the causes of our slow demise.